Welcome, and thank you for joining the webinar today. I'm Amanda Jadro, the Director of Portfolio Management at TRICOM. As an administrative and financial solutions provider to the staffing and consulting industry, it is our philosophy to be an active member of the staffing industry by staying abreast of the ever-changing marketplace. For that reason, TRICOM was pleased to launch the Industry Insider webinar series designed to share our expert knowledge and resources with our fellow staffing industry colleagues. One of our core values is to build relationships and become a leading resource to staffing and consulting firms nationwide. Our presenter today is Brian Slowick. Prior to Rapid Pay Card, Brian was both a board member and executive leader for Skilled Service Corporation, a Tampa Bay-based construction staffing firm that grew over 40 offices across the United States Sun Belt from 1993 to 2007. The company experienced a successful exit with an acquisition by what is now TrueBlue. Rapid brings robust services to payroll departments in a single platform. The combination of Rapid Pay Card, on-demand, and disbursements enables employers to cut costs and improve efficiency while giving employees the freedom to choose how and when they get paid. 78% of the U.S. workers are living paycheck to paycheck. Timing of payroll can cause employees to struggle with making ends meet. Many resort to requesting a payroll advance or short-term loan, placing them in an uncomfortable situation. In today's Industry Insider webinar, Brian will discuss how on-demand pay can empower your employees and what unexpected results can benefit from can actually benefit employers. With that, I will turn the floor over to Brian.
Thank you, Amanda. It's really a pleasure to be here today, especially with my dear friends from TRICOM, who have been wonderful partners over more than a decade. And we are thrilled to have the opportunity to speak with you and your interested parties on the line today. So thank you very much again. My name is Brian Slowick, and let's talk about on-demand pay and the best ways to pay in an emergency. Staffing can provide for some interesting dynamics that other businesses don't quite have to deal with. So I want to just give you a quick overview of the logistics for today's session. We do ask you to ask any of those unique questions that are very specific to staffing. As if you were in the same room, please go ahead and ask those questions in the chat box, and feel free to share or ask anything that you would like, and we will try to bring best practices to light with a response in the chat box by my colleague, Ed Cole, or we will follow up if necessary after this session. You've already heard who I am, so let's go ahead and get started with what we're going to talk about today. We're going to talk about on-demand pay and the best ways to pay in an emergency. I want to first address how we got here to where we are today and the gig economy and what type of influence that has had. My opinion is that the staffing industry is the first and original of the gig economy. And I want to address also how Rapid helps. So just a few months ago, and sadly, we're going to soon be able to change this to almost a year ago, we were hit with a very interesting scenario, some would say traumatic, with both our personal lives as well as our professional lives. As in St. Patrick's Day is what I call it, right around the middle of March is when everything was stopped and we all had to go home and figure out ways that we could continue to work in this world of COVID-19. We are living through probably a second and or some say third wave of the virus and are excited about the vaccine now being used, but it will still have a near-term impact into 2022, and you may have to adjust on the fly to recover from those, whatever those impacts may be, whether they're on a local scenario, regional, or national. But prior to COVID, you had 78% of U.S. workers living paycheck to paycheck just to make ends meet, with nearly 3 in 4 workers that have said that they are in debt today, and sadly more than half think they always will be. More than half of all minimum wage workers say they have to work more than one job to make ends meet. And again, that was all prior to the aspect of COVID-19. In today's world, it's probably worse. We had many of the employees that may have been double incomes within their homes, families, that now may be only living with one working spouse, or the aspect of that they're getting less hours. There's a whole variety of pressures that have come down on folks that are working today, and it needs to be addressed in some way or form, because oftentimes their obligations have not changed. But it is interesting to look at, and again, data that came out prior to COVID-19, I'm sure it has been exacerbated since COVID-19, but who is running out of money between paychecks? Across the country, it's 1 in 3 Americans or workers in all income levels are running out of money. Most people tend to focus on that less than $40,000 per year and assume that's where all the problem is. And yes, it is worse in that area. Oftentimes, around 40% have trouble making it to the next pay period. And that could be due to a variety of reasons, not only the job that they have, but also the status that they have in the workforce. Many of them are new to the workforce and such. There are all those types of aspects that play in. But it is also critical to look across all incomes, all the way over to, you know, over $200,000 on an annual basis, still have trouble making it to the next paycheck, with 32% at that level still struggling. Why is that? Lifestyles get in the way, oftentimes businesses, or more so the aspect of children are older, going to college, those types of aspects. And people need some way to fill that gap between their obligations and the paycheck. Sorry, I clicked one too fast there. Can't get that COVID slide to show up. Don't know why. But COVID-19 and what happened since then. Here is a seasonally adjusted chart, and it actually only goes up into July. It has continued to decrease in there, but 45 million Americans filed for unemployment during the height of COVID, which happened to be July 14 to July 11. Now that we are experiencing in many states increased lockdowns, as well as greater cases of COVID-19, we hope that we will not see that upturn again in the unemployment, but it is a possibility. And we need to be aware of what the options are for the employees as they struggle through that time. So 1 in 3 of the U.S. jobs have become possibly vulnerable or have proven to be vulnerable during COVID-19, where 80% of those jobs are held by low-income workers. So, and this is from McKinsey and Company. So these are the folks that are typically struggling to begin with, but will continue to be burdened as this pandemic goes forward. It's not all bleak news. In fact, there are companies that are, in fact, hiring. You have CVS, Walgreens, et cetera, that are actually hiring contingent workforce for the purpose of administering the vaccination program all across the country. So that's the healthcare group, of course, is seeing a rise. The other parts are home improvement stores and Costco's, Meijer's, dollar stores. Domino's, anything that relates to delivery. So Domino's, McDonald's, Subway, as long as the restaurant business has been able to switch over to delivery, they are actually hiring and doing very, very well. So there has been both winners and regrettably losers during this particular pandemic over 2020. And we anticipate that a lot of that is going to carry through into 2021. What industries are feeling the positives of COVID-19 is healthcare, food, grocery, and convenience stores, some retail sales, mainly on the logistics side, where they're dealing with deliveries, and then also telecommunications. What companies are looking for now to make it through this interesting period? And you know, we do want to think of it as a disaster because that's the way it's behaving for the majority of our entities. And what many of the companies are looking for is the possibility of enabling a backup plan for these particular emergencies where we can eliminate the touch points, eliminate that possibility of spreading the virus or making things worse, as well as also increasing the efficiencies of our methods of check disbursements and check mailing. We want to eliminate paper checks and drive to 100% electronic payroll, especially for the unbanked, but also for virtually anybody that comes to work for us, because we offer a tremendous benefit that can help the worker that is working for you, who is a dispersed workforce at all of your client sites, and you need to have the ability to get it to get their money into their hands seamlessly without any contact or burdens by you losing time to increase your personal revenue for your company. So companies are looking for methods that can deliver the cash-strapped employee with on-demand pay to help with those possible shortfalls and also provide you as an employer with a differentiator for coming to work for you, taking your posting versus maybe somebody else's. And the employers are looking for the capability to unlock tools for employees to pay bills and shop online, because many things have, of course, converted to the aspect that we can't leave our houses or we can't go to a physical location to pay that bill, and we absolutely are having challenges getting to stores, so shopping online has become virtually mandated or a heavy demand. We asked the American Payroll Association members what they thought regarding COVID-19, and 87% in the survey believe there would be a second wave of COVID-19. They would be proven to be accurate as we're starting to see that rise occur now that it's gotten colder, and 77% are prepared to move to 100% electronic pay in an emergency. Now, those are folks that are very active in the American Payroll Association, and it represents about 10% of the payroll profession across the country. So those are the best circumstances. My belief in working with payroll managers that are all across the country is you probably only have about 25% of all payroll managers that are prepared to go to 100% electronic pay in an emergency. Some because they just haven't prepared for it, others because they aren't sure that they can have a compliant means to do it in their particular states, et cetera. And we hope to address some of that in today's webinar. The best ways to pay in an emergency are, first off, you really should have a pay card to eliminate the need for in-person check distribution or check mailing for those folks that have not yet signed up for direct deposit. That does not mean that they're unbanked. That just means they have not signed up for direct deposit. And you should always allow somebody that has a bank account the ability to use their primary bank account as their main depository place to receive their pay. But having a pay card as a secondary direct deposit is always good, and it allows you to fill the gap while you're waiting for them to sign up with their primary bank account, if in fact they just haven't done so. The other aspect is, how do we help those employees with emergencies? And the number one emergency, why this young lady here is shown fixing her tire, is oftentimes the number one emergency that keeps them from getting to your posting or showing up on your job is transportation related. And you need to have some method by which that employee can actually gain access to the funds earlier than they normally would if they've already earned them, so that they can take care of that problem and decrease their absenteeism. One of the things that we are the provider with Rapid On Demand and Rapid Pay Card is we are the back-end provider for Uber drivers all across the country, and where they can get paid up to 5 times a day instantly. And that is why we've brought that technology to bear into the Rapid On Demand platform. But one of the things that we don't want to have happen is somebody make that decision that, hey, I can't go to my staffing posting today because I've got a flat or my car's not operating or I got to pay rent, whatever that might be. So I've got to go out and do a gig job for the next 6 hours so that I can gain that $60 to get that done, and I'll have to go to my posting job tomorrow. So that's where Rapid On Demand can really make a positive impact for you, as well as the capability of having the pay card as a reception point for that early access. Rapid offers comprehensive solution in order to do this and bring it all to play for you. The landscape is, in fact, competitive on both pay card as well as early wage access, which is what Rapid On Demand is a technology for early wage access. We do, in fact, have proven technology that is very, very scalable. It is, in fact, an e-payments platform, and we have extensive legal and regulatory compliance tools that we provide to TRICOM, as well as we can provide access to you should you have any questions. We also focus heavily on program implementation, continued training and support through our enrollment team, who becomes your free pay card department or early wage access department. And we try to provide you with expert communications and superior cardholder support for your employees, because a happy employee means a happy payroll department and a happy staffing company. PayCard can, in fact, be a true employee benefit, and not only, again, for the unbanked. It is a true, robust banking tool that is provided to any of your employees. We have plenty of folks that fall into the millennial generation, Gen Z, or the younger generations, where they're expecting you, as the employer, to be offering robust benefits, such as an online bank account. And that's what Rapid Pay Card provides you with. It enables cashless purchase and online shopping. It also reduces or eliminates fees and trips and or costs associated with check cashing, transportation and gas, money order purchases, and most importantly for our cardholders, is we never have overdraft fees. And that is the number one thing that our cardholders would like to avoid from a traditional bank account. The other aspect is there's no minimum balance, no monthly service charges, and unlike cash, the card can be replaced if lost or stolen, and it will not impact your payroll process at all. And most importantly for you as the employer, is there's zero cost to the employer for this wonderful benefit. And it does provide the employee the capability to use the Rapid Pay Card completely free if all they are looking to do is to cash their, replace the action of cashing a check. The other aspect is, how do we make money? We do, in fact, make money from the vendors or the retailers where our cards are accepted. It's something that is called interchange, and that's primarily how we are making our funds. Next, move on to this interesting question that says, if your CEO asked you for a loan, how would you react? Well, you'd probably be a little bit taken aback, et cetera, but quite frankly, that's really what we as business leaders are doing with the old standard of a two-week or one-week payroll delivery methodology, as we are utilizing those funds for the period of time while the employee has already earned them. And that is the way that our workforce views it today since the advent of the gig workforce. Because in the gig workforce, such as Uber, Lyft, et cetera, any of those app-based employments, you can access your money typically the day that you've earned it. And that's what we are bringing to play for you today. You're looking at an interesting picture here that many of you may be saying, how does this relate? Why are we looking at this picture? And if we were live, I would in fact be asking you, what is this? And some of you may know, some of you may not. I'm going to tell you that is the Tesla Cybertruck. It is supposed to be in production and first ones rolling out onto the road this coming spring. I think that will be aspirational, but in any case, when it first came out, my sons came running into me and said, Dad, you've got to see the Tesla truck. Let me show you the Tesla truck. And they were so excited, and I was interested to see it myself. And just like any new idea, when you first see it, you're going to have one of two reactions. It is usually the reaction of my sons, which was excitement and enthusiasm, or my reaction, which was, what in the world is that? And that is ugly, and it looks like something that I could build in my garage, or the first go-kart I built as a kid in, you know, the early 70s. And I thought it was just too much, too fast, too drastic of a change, and it put me back. And then over time, as I began to think about it more and look at it more, I began to see that I thought it was a very interesting vehicle, and what do you know, I now have a deposit on one, and I'm looking forward to getting one. Why do we have that? Why am I telling you that story? Is that is the way early wage access, or rapid on demand, was viewed from the marketplace when we first brought it forward. Is the majority of those leaders or business executives, and especially those in finance and payroll, said, too much, too fast, you're asking me to do daily pay, and I just do not like it one bit, and I won't accept it, and I won't ever use it, and et cetera. But now that they've had time to think about it and understand it, it is a more attractive possibility. I'm not saying they're all on board yet, but they're at least considering it. And part of the reason is understanding that it is a scalable solution that has really had a very, very positive impact with some of the major employers out there. As we stated, this is the exact same technology that Uber is utilizing for instant pay, and it has cashed out over $1.3 billion to drivers in just 1 year, and billions since. And it is oftentimes attributed as the number one reason why people will go to work for Uber is the fact that they can get paid as soon as they earn it, and they can get paid as much as five times a day instantly. Now, granted, that's not something that you're going to want to bring to the table, but the ability to get some level of pay prior to the traditional payday is very, very attractive to the workforce. Because our traditional, I'm a baby boomer, I'm that guy, the young man, I wish I were that young, we would possibly switch that to an old man, the old man on the left there, who's used to the 2 weeks or longer for a pay period, and workers have to wait, you know, for all of those aspects of traditional pay cycle and have nowhere else to turn to for that money. Maybe they're knocking on your door asking for an advance, versus the capability who can freelance and get paid as they earn it with instant pay. And that has dramatically turned the payroll timing in the workforce on its head. So 44% of gig workers in the U.S. have received either full or partial advance payment for their services, according to Payments Magazine. So if you have a gig experience or workforce that has tested out the gig marketplace, they know that it is possible to get paid instantly if the technology is put to bear in your own systems. So did you know that 75 million workers in the U.S. today are freelancers? That took me aback when I first saw it. And almost half of them, 47%, of the U.S. workforce freelance. Life doesn't wait for payday, and that's the problem that we're trying to solve. This young lady here is looking at the traditional piggy bank that, of course, is intended never to be opened unless it is truly needed in an emergency. And what do we do? You've got the dilemma. I know I've already earned my wages, but I don't get paid until Friday, but I must pay the power bill today or experience negative circumstances. So I may have to crash my piggy bank and really put myself behind. That's the problem that we're trying to overcome for your workers and make it so that they're more likely to show up to your job posting without having to go take some gig job in order to take care of an emergency expense. And almost 30% of the reasons why people need that instant funds or for emergency expenses. Others are also for very good reasons, which is in the high 20% for groceries, utilities, and or rent, which are all very good reasons for asking for an early wage access so that you can overcome those life instances that don't wait for payday. Sometimes it's just simply that the pay cycle doesn't line up with the requirements for paying those bills. And when that happens, the person is going to go find an alternative financial services solution that can get them access to the money so that they can overcome those emergency situations. And it doesn't matter that they're more costly and sometimes cause repeated bad behavior. It just needs to be solved. So they've got to go to some solution out there. They may go to a check casher where the fees can be median fee of 1.9%. That can be as much as $500 a year. They may go to a payday lender for a short-term loan, which can be somewhere between 7 and 14 days against the check. And that the median loan fee is 16.5%. Loan value of $300, a loan at 15% per year is 505% annual percentage rate. Just brutal. And then there's also the aspect of getting money orders just to pay a bill or sending wire electronically, which can be $10 to $25 per transfer. Wouldn't it be great to be able to provide your employees with a solution that is dramatically better and more convenient than that? And that is exactly how on-demand pay helps you and your employees overcome many of those problems. So let's talk about an example that should be somewhat of a reality for you or those of you listening in on today's webinar. Let's talk about Joe. Joe has a child and has an unplanned $300 expense because his child accidentally dropped his phone. And Joe must have that phone to get his work done, but he doesn't have access to credit, and it won't be paid for 5 days. What can Joe do? Well, Joe has the option to go to that check casher or payday advance lender down the street where he can borrow $300, and then he pays that $300 back plus $60 in fees in 2 weeks, or even worse, rolls it over for an additional fee. If he's a typical payday lender, payday loan user, he accesses 10 loans per year and is paying almost $600 in fees, and that has a tremendous financial stress on his overall financial well-being. But wouldn't it be great for Joe to have another option where he can simply go to his mobile device or his computer, and because he has already worked a few days, he can unlock responsible access to wages that he's already earned. And because life doesn't wait for payday, he can go ahead and do that without having to bother anybody on your staff or having to leave his home. Joe accesses some of those wages that you have allowed him to have access to through early wage accrual, and he has instant funds with a nominal transaction fee of, it says $5 here, but I will tell you that normally it can be as low as a dollar depending on the volume that your company is pushing through. Joe doesn't miss the job posting or a day of work. He doesn't stress. And most importantly, it takes the financial pressure off of his family by saving $550 in fees and not getting caught up in bad behavior of just constant spinning and turning over of that payday lending. Everyone out there that is working would love to get paid faster. In fact, we've surveyed folks, and this was done by the Fed, the Federal Reserve Board, and the opt-in rate for payroll wage advance for people under the age of 30, the survey stated that 100% would like to have access to early wage advance. Of those that would like access, 25% of them said they would access on-demand wage payments during any given payroll. So it is in high demand by your workforce, especially as we in the baby boomer generation start to fade out of the workforce. And COVID-19 has made the on-demand economy even more important than it was last winter, January through March. Today, we all live in that on-demand world, and on-demand is a solution for helping your employees in an emergency as well as just managing their personal finances in a more beneficial way. But what about you as the employer? How does this help you? This helps you by increasing your job applicants by about 30%. And improve your employee retention by more than 20%. And we focused heavily on our stories and discussion throughout this webinar on lowering workforce absenteeism. And the impact there is by lowering workforce absenteeism by about 40%, which is this area I like to really point to the lower workforce absenteeism in the staffing industry. Because that is what? That's direct revenue to you. Every time we can keep an employee on the job, even for an extra 15 minutes, it is a dramatic impact to staffing because that's billable hours, and that's direct revenue. It's more important to you in the staffing industry than it is in many of the other industries out there. I do know in running a staffing company, Skilled Services Corporation, back in the day, if we could keep our workers on the job site for an extra 30 minutes by not having them leave the job site to pick up a paycheck, that ended up being a dramatic increase in our revenue. In fact, we had one location in Miami, Florida, that throughout a year, by eliminating the need for the person to leave the job site early in all of our jobs in the Miami area, we were able to see an increase in revenue by $1 million out of the Miami location. So that's the other aspect that becomes very, very important to those of you on this call today. We also want to empower our employees to get paid how and when they like. That means the ability not just to get paid to our pay card, but the ability to get paid to any bank account, any debit card that they have, and that's the capability that can be available with Rapid On Demand, or even the ability to go to a retail location and pick up cash after they access the tool and request how they want to be paid. So it also enables you to get to 100% electronic payments with full disbursement compliance and consent tracking so that you can be sure that you make the legal requirements in every single state of employment that you may have, and also drive that employee engagement so that they want to work with you over the guy down the street, because early access to accrued wages makes your posting significantly more attractive than that guy down the street. So, best practices and how it works. How does Rapid On Demand work? First off, with our relationship, if in fact you are taking advantage of the back offices with Tricom, is Tricom takes much of these efforts and challenges off your plate, especially when it comes to pay card, because they can take all the issuance and all the challenges and easily put them in place. We work with hundreds of clients just like you all across the country with the folks at Tricom taking that burden on and working with us. But if you are taking care of it yourself, it is simply a daily file out of your corporate payment office, which interfaces with the payroll time and labor system, and we track that value by eliminate any of the risk. We are sure to have the policies in place so that you can adjust them to give access in the proper amount and frequency to your employees that makes you feel comfortable. You have total control to set those policies down to a branch level as well as on a your whole universe level. So as much flexibility as necessary, that sometimes becomes a real differentiator for you in recruiting. We have many folks that do gray collar staffing for folks from FedEx, UPS, Amazon, et cetera, and they all may be recruiting for the same business center where the person could actually go and take another posting over lunchtime if they so chose, and you may need to have the ability to set a different policy in that particular commerce center so that your job site is more attractive than the competitor. This Rapid On Demand policy engine allows you the capability to do that. The employees have access to their accrued wages instantly via the mobile app, the web, or telephone, and the funds are deducted from a subsequent payroll with a simple payroll deduction, and it is at the gross wage level, be listed on the pay stub, and the employee only receives the remaining net wages for which they are due. That is a critical differentiator based on the latest advisement that has come out of the Consumer Financial Protection Board, CFPB, and Rapid seems to have the model. Rapid On Demand has the model that most fits in the aspect that the payroll deduction is critical. On-demand payment is, in fact, an elected benefit. It is not something that needs to be taken advantage of. Except when the employee wants to take an advantage of, and it can be done seamlessly without you having to be bothered day in and day out. The employers are providing part of the wages that have already been earned for a period of days, so the process does not change your compliance responsibility or your normal wage cycle. It is simply allowing an employee the capability, if they so choose, to access some of the wages that they've already earned and do it in a very, very simple manner and get access to it instantly so that they may go on being a more productive employee for you. So what are the facts associated with this new offering out there of early wage access and oftentimes tied to a pay card is that the employer is looking for methods to increase their benefits without having greater costs because it is so competitive and our margins are tight to begin with. So are you having to pay for this? No, the employer is not having to pay for this unless you so choose. We do have some employers that have chosen to pay for an employee to have access to their wages early, but most are passing that fee on to the individual because it is not a high fee. It is just simply the employee is taking advantage of the convenience of getting paid early, and they so choose, and then it is done through the website or the app, and they elect it, and it's elected benefit. Does the company get to select how much is available to the employee? Yes, absolutely they do. That is what is so important about the control panel, the capability to set the policies. The policy engine is critical, and you can configure the percentage of accrued wages that are available, and you are always doing that on a net basis, and you're typically doing it at a very conservative amount that allows you to protect for garnishments or other demands that may come in later. So very simple to adjust and to be sure that you're never getting yourself in trouble with garnishments or child support. So what about early wage accrual, additional considerations, and where does the responsibility fall when it comes to compliance? Well, we as employers know that it always has to fall to us because the employer is in fact contracting with a third party who's providing that service on the employer's behalf. So rapid on demand and rapid as a whole, whether it be pay card or early wage access, we as the third party for you are really trying to do as much as we possibly can to give you information at the ready so that you can be sure that you are compliant and that we as a third party are not getting you into challenging situations. And we promise to do that with the tools that we already have in place, and we spend monies with the American Payroll Association as well as outside counsel to be sure that we keep all of our tools up to date so that you have the freshest information possible to be sure that we are in compliance collectively. Is there a contract with the employer for early wage access? There is, in fact, one, and all of the others out there in the marketplace will require you to do the same. So that, again, bolsters the aspect that the responsibility falls to you as the employer. And are you, in fact, as the offering of early wage access, providing your employee with pay choice? And what that means is multiple ways for the employees to access their money. We believe at Rapid that is a critical consideration for you to look at when you're looking at early wage access or you're looking at pay card, and we provide you with both. We do not force you to use just a card for early wage access. We allow you to get paid direct into your bank account or direct to any other debit card or pay card in the marketplace. And most importantly, all of the advances are always visible on the pay stub. So there's still a lot of mystery to a certain degree in a new marketplace. PayCard was very similar. When we started Rapid PayCard in 2003, the industry was quite new. Not many people even knew what a debit card was back then. Early wage access is somewhat similar in that regard, and we've been able to leverage our experience so that we now are able to have known unknowns, which we are addressing aggressively with folks like the IRS, the CFPB, which is the Consumer Financial Protections Board or Bureau, and also federal and state regulatory agencies, where we are working with the APA aggressively in order to try to get guidance and give you as much information as possible, leveraging our experience with pay cards in the past. I am, in fact, a member of Early Wage Access Subcommittee for the American Payroll Association as well as their pay card subcommittee. And we are doing all we can to get ahead of the curve and be sure that we are setting the stage so that the regulators are familiar with what this offering is, and I'm glad to say that they are, and are willing to move forward in a positive light, and I'm also glad to say that they're doing so. So with all that said, I hope that you have enjoyed the experience today to learn a little bit more about how to pay your employees in an emergency and how early wage access may in fact decrease your absenteeism and potentially therefore increase your revenue, and how Rapid Pay Card is a completely free benefit that is available to you through TRICOM to help for a more efficient pay process for your entity today and make your job postings more attractive than the competition. So we would like to ask you to make pay your best benefit yet and allow you to feel free to ask any questions that you might have today before we close out.
Okay, so go ahead and enter in any questions in the chat feature. If anyone has any questions on today's presentation, Brian did a really nice job of covering everything for us. And while they're thinking of anything, can you cover kind of what is the biggest question that you seem to hear from employers that are looking at this as an option that is new to them?
Well, let me separate it into two. Pay card is just oftentimes the aspect of I'm afraid that my employees aren't willing to accept it. And I can tell you up until about 6 years ago, that was a very valid concern. In today's workforce, as baby boomers have faded out, the number one concern is how can I get paid faster and how much does it cost? And pay card absolutely allows for you to get paid as quickly as possible, and it allows you a portable bank account that you can take to any employee or any employer or any job that you have in the future, and all kinds of robust benefits. Then when we go to early wage access or on-demand pay, the biggest question that we get is related to control. So the employer wants to be sure that if, in fact, they're going to, well, two things, control and time, that first off, they don't want to have to add something else that's going to cause people to interact with them day in and day out and keep them from doing their regular job. But also, if, in fact, they allow folks access to their pay early, is it going to get the employee into trouble? And also, do they have the ability to control it? Yes, they do. In both of those instances, with a simple setup on the policy engine, and then everything else is done electronically with a simple transfer of data, and it's all settled up on payday and keeps everybody happy. So those are the two main questions, Amanda.
Wonderful. Thank you. Okay. I'm not seeing any other questions come in at the moment. Where can we find more information for those that would like additional information on the services? Would you direct them to your website?
Absolutely. And also you can direct them to your internal team there at TRICOM.
Okay.
I do know for anybody that is doing back office, they're extremely familiar with the Rapid Pay Card. You have numerous clients that utilize the Rapid Pay Card today, and I know that Rick Gerke and his team there are extremely familiar, and we welcome you to go there. But you can also always go to rapidpaycard.com to find any information that you need. But I can tell you that everybody there at TRICOM does as good a job as we do in selling our services and understanding our services.
Wonderful. Absolutely. Well, that sounds great. I thank you so much for taking time out of your day to cover this important topic. and to share this information with our clients. Any final thoughts here before we wrap up today's session then?
My only final thought is thank you all to allow us to participate. Everybody have a happy holiday season and a happy new year, and we look for a fantastic 2021, and know that the Rapid Paycard team, Rapid team, is here to assist you in any way possible.
Wonderful. Thank you so much. And we will have a recording available on our website at trecum.com in our Industry Insider Resources tab. For anyone that would like to share this with others or within their team to view again. If anyone has any additional questions, feel free to reach out to myself or Rick Gerke also has a lot of information for TRECOM clients that might be interested in looking into this further. So with that, we thank you, and I hope you all have a wonderful afternoon.